Sir, August left.
Okay.
Yes, sir. It's going.
Okay, so we are talking about the different label converters, because I said that when signal will be transmitting or moving from one cluster to another cluster, from low level to high level or high level to low level, there could be an issue of signal mismatching, and this could be solved using the converters. This could be a high to low level converter when signal is transmitting from high level cluster to low level cluster, or it could be a low to high level converter when the signal is transmitting from low level cluster to high level cluster. Okay. So if you don't place the logic inverter, when we don't place a level converter, then there could be issue. So you can realize the issue by looking at this graph. Let's say that this is one of the element of the low supply level cluster, and the output of this inverter is driving another inverter, which is an element of a high voltage level cluster. Okay, so if the input here, if Vin is high, let's say, so the output will be zero in this case. The zero of this, the output of this low supply voltage cluster will be zero. And if this zero is being taken as an input by this inverter, which is getting operated, which is being operated at a high supply voltage, then of course there will not be any issue. But let's say that the input here is zero. So if the input Vin is zero here, then the output of the first inverter is high. It is one, and one now is not one now is a voltage level of VTDL. Okay. But this circuit, which is designed as at higher VDDH value, so for this circuit, the one level is VDDH. Okay, so one output here is at VDDL level, which is less than this VDDH. And there could be a situation where this VDDL will always be greater than the VTHN of this transistor, the threshold voltage of this transistor. But this VDDL could be smaller than that of VDDH plus VTHP of this transistor. Okay, so if the VDDL of this stage, if the VDDL level is between the VTHN of this transistor and the VDDH plus VTHP, the threshold voltage of this transistor, then in that case there will be problem. The problem will be the two transistors will be on together. Okay, when the input is high here, when the signal is high at the high level here, so that is going to turn this transistor on. But at the same time, this high level is supposed to turn this transistor off. But if the signal level here is less than VDDH plus the threshold voltage of this transistor, then that VDDL, the signal here, which has the level of VDDL, that cannot turn this transistor off completely. And in that case, there will be a short circuit. There is a possibility of the short circuit power dissipation. The two transistors will be on together. There will be a short-circuited path from VDDH to ground, and therefore be an undesirable power dissipation because of a temporary path available from VDDH to ground here. Okay. There could be another possibility where the signal is transmitting from high level, VDDH level, to VDDL level. Okay, so if a signal is being transmitted from high level cluster to low level cluster, and let's say that These are the two transistor. I mean, this transistor, this inverter circuit is now driving this transistor circuit. So in that case, again, there will be problem because the output, let's say that the input is zero in this case here. So if the input is zero, then the output of if input is zero here, then the output here is VDDH. And this circuit is not designed, however, for the input of VDDH. This is designed for only for the high level input of VDDL. Okay, so what will be the issue if the input here comes to turns out to be VDDH? So this VDDH is going to turn this transistor off, going to turn this transistor on. That is okay. But this transistor, this VDDL, this VDDH here is going to appear at the gate of this P transistor, and this is basically a large voltage than the expectation voltage, than the expected high level for this transistor, and that large voltage, which is also a kind of negative voltage for get to a source of this transistor, positive voltage in fact for this transistor. So that will give rise to a huge GIDL current in this transistor, because this transistor is supposed to be off for high input here, but this will be in off condition, but the input voltage is so high that it will induce the gate induced drain leakage current, which is a kind of leakage current. We'll be discussing about this in detail when we'll be talking about the techniques of minimizing the subthreshold, techniques used for minimizing the leakage current. So both way there will be issue. Even if the signal is transmitting moving from low level to high level, or high level to low level, when it is moving from low supply level to high supply level, there will be problem of short circuit power dissipation. When it is going from high signal zone, high supply voltage zone to low supply voltage zone, there could be a problem of GIDL, and that could be a source of the power dissipation. So to minimize these two, what could be done to minimize these two? A level converter is placed in between, and when the signal is to move from high supply to low supply level, we have to use a high to low level converter, and vice versa. So a high to low level converter is shown here. A high to low level converter, basically this is a kind of buffer. You can see the two CMOS inverters connected back to back, but this is the two transistors, the two inverters are being operated at low supply voltage level. Okay, so in case there is a high input level here, V, which is VDDH, so VDDH here becomes zero, and this zero input here comes out to be VDDL. Okay, so high output level will become high output level goes only to VDDL level. Okay, so this is a simple circuit for high to low level converter. Another circuit is shown in the next slide for low level to high level converter. So for low to high level converter, the dual cascode voltage switch DCVS, this is a conventional low to high level converter, and the circuit is you can see the two folded transistors are used here. MP1, MP2 are the P transistor. The input is given here, and there is an inverter here which is operated at low supply level VDDL. Then there is a N transistor. This end of this MN1 is actually grounded, source is grounded, and the output of this VDDL, the output of this inverter is given to another inverter here, which is also being operated at low supply level, and the output of this inverter is given to this transistor MN2, and the source of this transistor is also ground. Okay, so when input is zero, at the zero level, of course there will not be any issue. When the input is at the zero level, then the output of this inverter is VDDL, and this VDDL, since is greater than the threshold voltage of this transistor VTHN, then transistor goes on. And when this transistor goes on, then since this is at the ground level, this Q, node Q, goes at low potential, and this low potential will actually turn this P transistor on. And if this P transistor is on, then if P transistor is on, then the potential here goes up, and this high level potential, this node is actually connected with the input of this inverter, which is being driven at the high supply level, and this high input level here, basically VDDH, which is going to ensure the zero output level here. Okay. If the input, however, is at high level, at VDDL level, then this inverter, if input is VDDL here, the output must be zero here, and this zero output will turn this transistor off. But this zero output will be the input to this another inverter, and here the input will be high at the VDDL level. So this VDDL level will turn this transistor on. And if this transistor is on, the potential here goes to zero, and the zero potential will turn this transistor on, this P transistor on. So potential here will go up, and this high potential level will ensure that this transistor is in off condition. So potential here will remain at the zero level. And if the potential here is zero, at which is the input of this inverter, the output is ensured at the VDDH level. So the input 1, which was at the VDDL level, now the output here is translated to the VDDH level. So that will solve the problem. So these converters, low to high level and high to low level converters, are used when multi-level supply voltage scaling is done. When there are more than one supply voltage levels are present in a given system or given circuit, then these converters have to be essentially used in order to match the signal level. Okay, so let us stop here today. Now I'd like to take some questions if you have any. Okay, so at a time, only one person will turn his mic on and can ask a question. Okay. And you can also share your experiences. I mean, if there is any issue, any problem, then you can also discuss that with me.
In the DC
PA. Yes.
Sir, in the DC PA, when one transistor, that is, sir, when the first inverter is on.
Just 1 minute. So who is talking?
Sir, myself, Ovidya.
Okay, so just ask your question.
Sir, first inverter on हो रहा है तो सर M1 on मतलब input जब high है तब सर M1 on हो रहा है, that is sir lower NMOS on हो रहा है तब सर
in this circuit, are you talking okay, so I have to show again share this desktop. Okay. Can you see the slides? Hello?
No, sir.
No, sir.
You cannot. think there is a technical glitch.
Try to share your desktop screen again.
I am trying, but actually it's not sharing. Okay, can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what actually you are talking about this transistor MN1?
Sir, MN1 is on. Sir, as MN1 is on, then sir Q will be 0. And sir,
yes.
And sir, MP2 will be turned on, and yes, then the output will be sir 0. That is, out will be 0.
Output will be 0. When MP2 is on, then this QB will go to VDDH level, and because of the input of this inverter is at VDDH level, the output will be at low level. Okay, that will be 0.
Sir, what about MN2?
If the MN1 is on, okay, means this output of this inverter is at high level, okay, so output of this inverter at the low level, so at the same time this MN2 will be in the off condition.
And sir, when input is different, that is sir, when MN2 is on.
When MN2 is on means the input is at the high level, VDD L level, then input is 1. If the input is 1, then here the output will be 0, here the output will be 1, and then only this MN2 will be on. So in that case, MN1 will be in the off condition.
And sir, as MN2 is on, then MP1 will be turned on.
When MN2 is on, then this MP1 is turned on. Yes.
And then sir, what will be the output?
The Q is high in that case, means MP2 is off, and QB is at the zero potential, a low potential level. So output is at VDDH level. So the input VDDL level is now translated to map to output VDDH level. So that was the objective to be achieved.
Okay.
Any other question? Do you have a class at 11? Any other class? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Which class?
Pandey sir will take VLSI technology.
Okay, okay. Then okay. If anyone will have a problem, you can also call me. Okay, you can ask question through over the phone. All right. From tomorrow onward, I will ensure that there will be 10 minutes per discussion. Okay. So I will stop early, and you will also let me know when the 10 minutes will be left, so that we'll have enough time for discussion or any doubt. For today's class, if you have any issue, either you can write me an email or you can also call me. Okay, we can discuss over the phone. Is it okay?
In between the lecture.
Okay, you can also ask in between the lecture. There is no issue. So at that time, you will turn your mic on and you ask your question. Okay, so it will be also appropriate if you ask at the time when the doubt comes to your mind, and if the relevant slide is also there on the screen, it will be also easy to explain. But make sure that only one person will turn their mic on at the particular instant of the time, so that we can avoid the technical glitch if there will be any. Okay. Okay, so I hope that you like this lecture. Okay, if you have any specific issue, technical issue especially, then you write one email to me, that I will forward to the competent authority, so that necessary actions will be taken. Okay, so okay. Thank you very much for joining me. Tomorrow we'll continue this topic. Okay, bye bye.
Bye bye, sir.
Have a good day. Yes, sir.